in a required formula. Okay, so if we observe this, this can be written as tan inverse 2 to the power x plus 1 minus 2 to the power x by 1 plus 2 to the power x plus 1 into 2 to the power x. We get the same thing. How? Tan inverse, we get 2 to the power x common, 2 minus 1 divided by 1 plus 2 to the power x plus 1 into 2 to the power x. Both are same. So we apply tan inverse A minus B by 1 plus AB. So if we apply the same formula, what we get? Tan inverse 2 to the power x plus 1 minus tan inverse 2 to the power x, which is equal to y. So dy by dx is equal to 1 by 1 plus 2 to the power x plus 1 whole square into d by dx of 2 to the power x plus 1 minus 1 by 1 plus 2 to the power x whole square into d by dx of 2 to the power x, which will result us as 1 by 1 plus 2 to the power x plus 1 whole square into 2 to the power x plus 1 into log 2 minus 1 by 1 plus 2 to the power x whole square into 2 to the power x log 2. Now he is asking at x equal to 0, what happens? Now we substitute x equal to 0 in both the cases. So dy by dx. So dy by dx at x equal to 0, we get 2 to the power 1 into log 2 divided by 1 plus 2 to the power 1 whole square minus 2 to the power 0 log 2 and divided by 1 plus 2 to the power 0 whole square. Finally, we get log 2 is common. So what we get is 2 by 5 minus 1 by 2. So resultant can also be written as log 2. 2 2s are 4, so minus 1 by 10. Or this can be written as minus 1 by 10 log 2. You can observe option D is correct, minus 1 by 10 log 2. So very important formula what we use here. I write once again the formula written in this: tan inverse A minus tan inverse B is equal to tan inverse A minus B by 1 plus AB. When these type of problems are written, we always try to bring in a form of tan inverse A minus tan inverse B or tan inverse A plus tan inverse B. This is the concept used in this.